and I got my man brother Roy, and we're gonna talk about how the court system do you, how your POs do you, and some advice you can give these youngers out here so they won't be in these situations, or how, if they in a situation.
Now it's like I'm supposed to come off parole this year.
Right.
I've been out for 15 years, violation here and there, technical violations.
Right.
And it took my street time, 8 years street time, and put it on my back number off a technical violation.
Right.
You know, so instead of coming off this year, now they're telling me I come off 2025.
God damn.
Now, the people, that I was talking to in the system, one of their people said it, she said this. There's no way in hell that they should be taking 8 years street time from you. She said, I'm watching guys catch new criminal cases.
Right.
And you're not even catching criminal cases. You keep a job.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? She said, you do stuff like catch a dirty girl from marijuana and then, But you're not catching new cases. You're not out here carrying no guns, selling drugs.
Right.
You working. You doing productive things, being with your kids. Mm-hmm. Why take 8 years street time from him and put it on his back number and keep him on paper?
Right.
And that's taking up a spot to somebody that actually used that case manager, mm-hmm, or that USP parole officer.
Right.
Better than pay attention to these kids out here that's smoking this K2 out here in front of my business,
right,
passed out. And, I got to come out here and bring them water, make sure they alive, man.
Right.
That's how kids out here.
Right.
And they worried about me. My case is almost 30 years old.
Dang.
I ain't caught no new cases.
Right.
Almost 30 years old. Yeah. I ain't caught, no charges, man.
Right.
But yet, you still holding on to me for what? Because then when you holding on to me, and then you want me to come and see you twice a week. Why?
Right.
You know I'm working.
Mm-hmm.
You know where I stay.
They want you to fumble.
Exactly.
Right.
Because I got a problem with authority, so let's apply some pressure to him. As soon as we apply some pressure, he's going to become the gingerbread man. He's going to stop reporting.
Right.
Then we can send him in, make money off of him when he go in, then take his street time and hold him for another 8 years. Because
right,
that's just what they did to me.
Right.
They just violated me because I failed to pay a fine,
right,
in Virginia.
Thank you.
And you give me 18 months for it? Come on, that don't even make sense. But you got guys going in with new cases, they get a 6 month hit.
Black or white?
It don't matter, black or white. The white guys don't come in. Unless they on heroin.
Right.
Cracked out.
Right.
The other ones, they come in, they get, personal charges.
So you already see them imbalance.
Come on. I did 26 months in Fairfax, Virginia. There's nothing in the world like it.
So what we got to do is find us a black lawyer that can look into the system.
But it's not just about,
yeah,
finding a black lawyer to look into the system. We got to start doing it ourselves.
I'm talking about that so we can bring a civil suit.
Yeah. I mean, you know how many suits they passed out against them?
Right.
I'm talking about when I was out there, they tased the young lady and killed her.
Right.
I know firsthand, that's the first thing they do. They tased me twice.
Mm-hmm.
They tased me because I lost two sisters.
Right.
Well, and I got a right to be emotional.
Right.
I'm telling you, shut my door. Leave me alone.
Right. So right there, that's psychiatric issue. That we look into getting you a civil lawyer to bring against it. It's about who apply the most pressure. We hold press conferences and shit.
They cut
a check and let you go.
When I was out there, you had the guy to go down there on the square down there, where the court building is,
right,
with the shotgun.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He got out.
White dude.
I ran from the police. I got 5 years.
God dang. That shit don't do.
Come on, that don't make sense.
Yeah, that shit don't make sense. You already see the injustice.
He out there with live ammo. In D.C. Right there in front of the federal and district court building. FBI building down the street. Police headquarters right there. I'm like, really? Let me have did that.
Man, your ass wouldn't have made it.
They would have came to my house.
They wouldn't have came. Yeah, shot your ass right there.
No, because all them police right there, how you just not see him?
Right.
Let a black man been down there holding the gun.
Right.